ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಟುಡೆ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟೀಚ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎನ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಂಗ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಐ ಹವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಡಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎನ್ ಸಿಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಫರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎನ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೈಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಇನ್ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ಎನ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಕೋಡಿಂಗ್, ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡನ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ. Okay, the today's agenda is for discussing an inbuilt primitives and a gate level modeling in an example. Okay, let us see what all the primitives it is available. Okay, the basic primitives it has been already available in a system is, you can see an AND gate, NAND gate, OR, NOR, XOR, XNOR, buffer, NOT. Okay, while discussing about a syntax of a gate level modeling, I have just taken as an example of an AND gate, how it can be called. Okay, here usually we can take an input wire or an output wire. If it is required, you don't specify wire also, by default it is going to consider an input output as a wire. The only thing you want to make sure is, while writing an behavioral description, at that time output need to be written as an range. Okay, not to call an AND gate, we are going to take it as an AND. There is an instantiation name within some name we are going to call inside this program. The first port I have already discussed, it is an output port. That's why the variable what we have declared it as an Y we have considered. Next ports are an A and an B. These are the inputs. In the same way, we are going to call for a NAND. The only the thing you need to remember is the names in order to call the particular names. It is not a big task. For equivalent gates, it has been with an equivalent name itself. For AND, it has been with an AND. Okay, it is not case sensitive. Either you can write it in a caps lock or in small letters. NAND, OR, NOR, XOR, XNOR. Okay, until for all the gates it remains same, except for your buffer AND and NOT. Okay, while discussing in gate level modeling syntax itself, I have told that it can be increased for the number of inputs. Okay, either it may be in 3 input AND gate or in 4 input NAND gate. The maximum it can allow in this software or in Verilog tool is, it is an 8. And 8 inputs you can have, only one output for an equivalent gates for until the XOR. Okay, when it comes to an buffer, it has an one input and an one output. The first port is an output, next port is an input. What happens if a buffer need to drive for an three outputs? This need to be connected for some three functions. At that time, how you can utilize this one from a buffer function? Okay, you can specify out 1, out 2, out 3 at the starting. Only the last port is going to consider as an input. The first coming ports have been considered as an output. The special case for a buffer. Okay, in all the cases, only the first port is output, all the ports are an input. But in the buffer, the first port, last port is an input, first coming ports are an outputs. Okay, for NOT, it has an output first, then an input. Okay, like that you can add a control signal for a buffer and a NOT. That is like a buffer if 0 or a buffer if 1. With a control signal is 0, it is going to transfer. Otherwise, it is going to declare it as an off state. In the same way, you can have for a NOT also. Those things it has been not discussed here. That is as an extension. If you want, you can refer the materials. Okay, now let us see in some example how we can write a circuit. Okay, here I have taken in some simple example for a 4:1 mux. Okay, if you are seeing a 4:1 mux, if you have a basic idea of a multiplexers, you will be known that it is going to have an 2 select lines. Based on that select line option, it is going to take the input to the output. If your select line is 0, 0, it is going to take an A. If it is 0, 1, it is going to take an B input to an output. If it is 1, 0, it is going to take an C input to an output. If it is 1, 1, it is going to take an D input to an 0. Okay, if you see an internal structure of this 4:1 mux, it looks like this. Okay, now let us, if you want to write a gate level modeling, if it is this structure, Okay, what all the things first we want to look for? Okay, first let us see how many gates it required in order to implement this 4:1 mask. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 gates are required. Out of these gates, let us see how many NOT gates. 2 NOT gates are required, 4 AND gates are required, 1 OR gate is required. Okay, let us see if you all try to write this NOT gate. Select line is from here. Okay, I can get an output, but straight away it is going for an output. Okay, here how can I relate this one? In order to relate the intermediate signals, we can declare those signals as an wires. Okay, let us see how many intermediate signals are there. From here to here, it has an on signal. W1 is required for a NOT gate of an S0. Then S1 NOT gate, another is required. This is an W2, it has been considered. Before giving it to an OR gate, all the 4 outputs of an AND gates is an intermediate signal. For an outside environment, it looks only Y, S1, S0, I0, I1, I2 and an I3. Rather than ABCD, I have considered as an I0, I1, I2, I3. This is the general rules we will follow there. Okay, the total intermediate signals required are W1, W2, W3, W4, W5 and W6. These signals are required. Okay, now let us try to write the code for this one. Okay, in the module declaration, we have taken as a module name as an MUX421. Here I have taken it as an Y, I and an S. Okay, you may be thinking there is an I with an I0, I1, I3 and an S with an S1 and an S0. Here I have not declared all the 7. Okay, here we have tried to write the inputs with an vector. Okay, the vector declaration is here 320i. It means nothing but it has an 4 vectors of an input. Okay, not to access each bit, we can select a I of 0, I of 1, I of 2, like this one, we can access individual bit. Like that, select line is an 2 bit, here we have taken 1:0 as an S and an Y. If the vector length is different, always you need to write it in a separate line itself. Okay, otherwise it is going to give it as an error if you are compiling with any of the software like an Xilinx or an Vivado or an any model sim like those things. Okay, the intermediate wires have been declared here, W1, W2, W3, W4, W5, W6. Okay, first thing is in the design block, we want to write a NOT gate. Okay, if you go back to the slides, here the S0 output is W1, S1 output is W2. That's what here we have been written. Then for an AND gate, here it has 3 inputs. While discussing a primitive gates, I have shown an only 2 examples. Here it has 3 inputs, means while calling this gate, W3 is an output, inputs are W2, W3 and an I0. Okay, that's why here I have written as an W3. These 3 ports are an input. Okay, if it wants, still it can be extended. In the same way, we will go for an W4 outputs, second AND gate and third AND gate and a fourth AND gate. Here we have written 3 inputs and then 3 inputs. But for the last gate, we have 4 inputs. Here you can see W3, W4 and Y is the output. Here you can see the result. Y, W3, W4, W5, W6. I think this is the design block you want to write. If any of the circuit is given, I think you can easily write. Only the intermediate signal need to be written with an wire, and then the input fashion how you are going to declare it is left to you, whether you are going to declare it as a vector or you are going to write it as a separate variables, you can write it. If you are writing as a separate variables, the number of variables required will be moved to a very high. Okay, if you want to make it very simple, you can go for a vector notation. I think like this we are going to give some of the circuits for you. You need to write by yourself. If you have any queries, you can just raise your queries there in the boxes. We will come to you. Thank you.